I first got involved with Kids Inc. with my son in basketball, and he played for several years. We transitioned from basketball into flag football, from flag football into tackle football. But the neat thing is they got to play with those kids from football all the way through. And so I've watched not only my son grow up, but the other kids grow up together. And now they're transitioning into seventh grade football. They're prepared. They have not only the football abilities that they need to have to play, but they have the sportsmanship and the things they've been taught that are more important even than the talent on the field. My daughter played soccer. We got a chance to coach. That was a fantastic experience. We probably were the last people on the planet that should have coached soccer because I'm not a soccer player. But it was a bunch of little kids, and we spent a lot of time Googling practice, you know, what kind of drills to do. And it was at times like herding cats, but it was so much fun. And I think every parent should coach at least one sport. I think it's about stepping outside your comfort zone. And if you're the reason that we did is we were basically the kids don't have anybody to coach them, and if there wasn't a coach, they don't get to play. And I can't think of a worse situation. And if every parent would just coach at least once, then it would take the burden off of the parents that coach all the time. But it also shows them a side of their self that they wouldn't get to see. I was a little nervous about coaching kids play soccer, but it's not about the soccer skills. It's about teaching the kids to be competitive, teaching the kids to be respectful, teaching the kids to listen to what you're trying to tell them. And those are life lessons. And I think we all have time to give one season to coach. And I think everybody should step outside their comfort zone and give that a try. And it truly does give you a whole new perspective on what the coaches and referees have to do to juggle, not only teaching the kids, but dealing with the parents and helping those kids grow. And it's a great experience, and I can't think of a better organization to have my kids in. You know, the competition is one thing, but the look on a kid's face when he's able to get out there and play. I can even use my son as an example. He wasn't the best basketball player to ever play. As a matter of fact, he struggled a little bit, but he was given the opportunity to go out there and even funneled the ball so he could at least score. He was able to, the scoring wasn't what it was about. It was the fact that the kids were rallying behind him to help him be successful. And I think that transitions more than anything, teamwork and into the business world of, you're only as good as the weakest link in your team. And to support all the people in the team, not just the guys that are the A players, is huge. Well, I think anytime you have that common ground, that child that no matter what, every person in that family wants to see that child do well, wants to see them have fun. And I think that only helps to bring that out in the parents and the people that may not otherwise get together. But they know that their child or their grandchild is out there playing and they get a chance to see them have fun is the key to bringing those families together. One thing that I've always appreciated is in the coaches' meetings or parents' meetings is the honesty and the integrity that Jimmy displays and what's important about it. It's important. It's the kids that's important. And I think as long as everybody keeps the kids in mind, this thing will continue to grow and continue to be as awesome as it is.